Life under the sea is better than anything they got up there.
The seaweed is always greener in somebody else's lake. You dream about going up there, but that is a big mistake. Just look at the world around you, right here on the ocean floor. Such wonderful things around you. What more is you looking for? Under the sea, under the sea. Darling, it's better down where it's wetter. Take it from me.
Please stand for the pledge. I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America, and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Okay, let's talk about pi for a minute. You remember pi, right? Number of times bigger a circle's circumference is than its diameter? It's a little more than 3. We could call it 3.14, or 3 and a 7th, and be accurate enough for most applications. You could use 39 decimal places of pi and be accurate enough for all applications. But pi's digits keep on going forever. And they're random, so that means you could find your birthday in pi. Mine occurs at the 33,870th decimal place. But what about something longer, like a phone number? My 7-digit phone number doesn't occur in the first million decimal places. But because the digits are random and unending, I'm certain to find it if I look far enough. In fact, for this reason, you can find any number you look for somewhere in pi. Let's switch to binary for a bit. Pi looks like a sequence of zeros and ones, but they're still random and unending. That means any sequence of digits will turn up if I look far enough. Computer files are just binary strings, so we could find your favorite MP3 down the line. We could find a picture of you in there, or a picture of what you'll look like in 10 years. It's not likely we'll find a particular sequence of digits quickly and easily, but we can rest assured it's in there. There's the sound of your first words, a video of your 10th birthday party. Your DNA is in pi, along with the DNA of every other creature, every YouTube video, every Wikipedia article. Every piece of information that will ever exist is sitting there already, somewhere in those digits. So think about that the next time you see a circle.
Good morning, Mahwah.
Today is Friday, March 15th, day 3 with labs.
Seniors, we have 98 days till graduation.
Thunder Vision starts right now.
Good morning, Mahwah High School. Hojung and Tyler here with Thunder Vision and the Friday morning announcements.
Our club will be meeting every Tuesday from now through the art show in May. If you're interested in helping out, please join us next Tuesday after school in room 113 until 3:30.
The Class of 2021 Equal Exchange Fundraiser will be going on through next Friday, March 22nd. Find a sophomore if you're interested in purchasing organic chocolate, coffee, tea, hot cocoa, or olive oil. And sophomores, don't forget, the top 3 sellers will win a gift card to Moe's.
Don't forget to support all of our performers, stage crew, and staff this weekend, and come see The Little Mermaid.
And now to SGA News.
Good morning, Mahwah. Cormac and Jenna here with a few announcements.
On March 28th, we will be hosting a blood drive for anyone 16 and older. If anyone is interested, please pick up a form outside the SGA office and see Ms. Paisa to sign up for a time slot. Make sure to do this so that you do not receive a cut for missing class. Remember, it's for a good cause.
Our next Thunderbird Thursday will take place this Thursday, March 21st. As always, make sure to come to school wearing your favorite Mahwah apparel and give your Period 1 class a chance to win an ice cream party at the end of the year.
Finally, don't forget to vote by the end of the day for the math teacher you want to see get pied in the face. Now back to Thunder Vision with the weekend weather report.
I don't even want to wear this fish costume. Where's my coffee? I'm not doing the weather without my coffee.
Good morning, Mahwah High School. It's your corresponding weather professional, Paul Kuipers, with the weekend weather. As you can tell right now, it's a little cloudy outside, but the nice warm temperatures around the 60s. For this weekend, you can expect it to be in the 40s with clear skies. But that's all. Make sure you go out and see the play this weekend. And that's all for me here with the weather. Now back to you for MHS Social.
Come on, fish!
No, I don't wear my...
Life under the sea is better than anything they got up there.
The seaweed is
is always greener in somebody else's lane.
Thanks, Paul. I had the opportunity to speak with a former college basketball player who was nice enough to send us a video about his thoughts on this year's college basketball tournament.
He certainly has a memorable past with this tournament, as he was a member of one of the great Cinderella stories in NCAA tournament history.
Back in 2013, Sherwood Brown led 15-seeded Florida Gulf Coast all the way to the Sweet 16 with thrilling wins over Georgetown and San Diego State. This FGCU team is the first 15-seed to ever make the Sweet 16, and Sherwood was the centerpiece of this magical run. Let's see what he has to say about this year's tournament.
Yo, what's up, Mahwah High School Thunder Vision? It's your boy Sherwood Brown here, coming to you live from Eastern Europe, but representing Florida all day. I'm here to talk to you a little bit about my favorite part of the year, and that's March. What's that mean? March Madness, baby. It's the time of the season where every team look forward to, the reasons that they put in all that hard work and all those long hours. I still remember the year 2013 when my squad, FGCU, aka Dunk City, made it all the way to the Sweet 16. March Madness is a very exciting part of the year where your team only got to be the best for that one night. This year, I'm expecting another underdog to bring the heat, and I'm talking about Murray State. Let's get it!
Just like Sherwood said, it's finally the most wonderful time of the year, the NCAA tournament. Personally, it's my favorite week of the year.
Your favorite week isn't the last week of school?
Nope, this is better. 68 teams come to the tournament all with one goal in mind, and that's to win the national championship.
So we went around the school and asked students and faculty members about their thoughts on this year's tournament.
Here's what they had to say in this week's MHS Social.
Here with big-time college basketball fan, Mr. Gliotta. Mr. Gliotta, who do you think is going to win the NCAA championship?
I'm going with UVA this year. I think they choked last year. I think they got a lot to prove, so I think UVA is going to take it all.
UVA, definitely, because my best friend's going there.
Definitely either UNC or Duke, because those are the best two basketball teams that I know of for college. So
I think UNC will win the national championship because of their Mahwah colors.
I'd have to say definitely Tennessee, because they are my favorite school, and I would be going there if my mom would let me. So definitely Tennessee.
I think Duke's going to be pretty hard to beat. They have a healthy Zion, but you never know if he's going to get through the entire tournament with an injury.
Loyola Chicago is going to win the national championship this year. What do you got?
I got Virginia all day.
Syracuse.
Definitely Kentucky.
I'm probably taking Texas Tech. They got my boy Jarrett. He's tough.
Duke's going to win.
Michigan State's got it this year.
North Carolina, Tar Heels, I think we'll be able to take it home.
It's going to be such an interesting tournament. Who do you want to win, Tyler?
Well, I'm really hoping for my Duke Blue Devils to get all the way back to the big dance, to face off in a classic game against somebody like North Carolina or Kentucky, and then for Zion to absolutely dominate the other team. Who do you want to win?
I don't know. Are the Lakers in the tournament?
Yes, Hojo. The Lakers are in the tournament.
Yay! Go Lakers! Peer through teachers, back to you.
Let's get it.